Three have become four. Prince George, pictured here just before his first birthday, now has a little sister. And just like him, the new baby is destined to be an object of global fascination. It was last September that in her absence, due to acute morning sickness, Catherine's second pregnancy became headline news.
How's Catherine feeling?
She's feeling okay, thanks. It's been a tricky few days, week or so, but obviously we're immensely thrilled. It's great news.
And you know they think you're out of Frozen.
In the months since, from here in Harlem, New York, to the set of Downton Abbey, the media spotlight has been trained on the expanding royal bump. Her final day of engagements came at the end of March when she and the Duke visited charities in South London. And then the waiting began. Royal births have always captured the headlines. The same hospital 33 years ago, and the first pictures of William were beamed around the world. 21 months ago, hundreds of journalists and camera crews camped out to see Prince George. And although the media interest in him hasn't waned, he has been deliberately kept out of the spotlight. These pictures from Australia were taken in April 2014, the last time the media were allowed to film the young prince. As he and his new sister grow up, they will at least be able to share the pressures of being in the public eye, just as William and Harry have done.
They will always be an object of curiosity. They will always be police protection officers with them. They will never be quite as ordinary as they would like to be. And having a close sibling, I think it was certainly invaluable for William and Harry when they were growing up, and is still today, and I think will be for George and his little chum.
The new royal baby will divide her time between the family's London base, Kensington Palace, and their new home, Anmore Hall in Norfolk. The Middletons will be on hand to help with their first granddaughter, and no doubt help Prince George get used to the idea that he's no longer the baby of the family. Sarah Campbell, BBC News.